diversity. Just giving you a quick roundup and a chance to win a free trip with us. Tag a mate or anybody you know into this video and or comment, and we'll put you in the draw to win a trip sometime over the next 3 months, so you get the best of the spring fishing. Speaking of which, today is the 1st of September, and you'd look outside, you wouldn't exactly think that it's spring. Certainly sprung a leak, and lots of rain and lots of wind, a northerly gale warning in force for the Hauraki Gulf at the moment, so probably not the very best of conditions to be out there, to be honest. Anyway, we'll give you an update of what's been going on with us. We've been fishing up around Little Barrier, Five Mile Reef, some of the other places up there, Cod Rock, and over towards Horn Rock. It's been a little bit patchy, to be honest, and the fish that we did get onto in our last trip were all relatively small snapper through there. However, we did pick up quite a variety of different fish, all the way from blue cod, terakee, sharks, porri, and just numerous other species that come up out of the deeper water there. Probably the best thing to do if you're up in that area at the moment would be to move into the shallows, maybe anchor and burley, and give that a shot, or maybe soft bait the shallows too, which would be a pretty good thing to do at the moment. I prefer the southern and eastern sides of Little Barrier for that sort of thing. I've also done pretty good around the northeastern corner and out in 50 metres through to about 70 metres on the northern side as well. The whole place really is riddled with reefs and lots of different structure and heaps of opportunity, so a pretty good area to target this time of year. The other place we've been targeting has been out off the top of Coromandel when the tides have been smaller. You really need less than about 3.1 or 3 metre tide over there. The reason is that the rip's pretty strong, and most of our fishing, as you know, is done on the drift, and to make the most of that, you don't want to have a very fast drift. So although diversity is 30 tonnes, can still get picked up and whistled along pretty quickly, especially right in that coval channel. So smaller tides over there. Probably the best areas we've been finding have been in between the Happy Jacks and Gannet, and also out off Fantail and Goat Bay in about 50 metres. Also further north through to sort of west of Channel Island, maybe 2 to 4 miles, and even northwest of Channel Island up towards Horn Rock a bit more, about 2 to 4 miles through there too. Again, drifting has been the key thing we've been doing there, and probably finding that the darker colours seem to be going best, so your orange, your amber, new penny, things like that seem to be the best colours. Also the slider in Candy Apple Green, that was going pretty good there as well, although I didn't really have enough weight to get down on the last, and I only hit 60 grams, and I was getting dragged along with it. So make sure you carry enough weight to do the job there. Other areas that have been working consistently well for the smaller boats has been out off Army Bay in the Whangaparoa Bay area. There's been a lot of fish being caught there by the kayak fishermen and also by small boats, soft baiting mostly. So I reckon dawn and dusk through there, anchoring in Berlin, would be a pretty good shot as well. Other places to try at the moment would be in the top of the Firth, sort of between Gannet and the Happy Jacks like I mentioned, and even further down. Maybe down off Poanui, across towards Cow and Calf as well. Won't be too much longer and we'll start to see the back of Carwell and Whangaparoa Bay start to really fill up. I know there's oodles of pilchards there and stacks of bait. So, you know, I'd say another month we're really going to start seeing a lot more activity in that area. So we'll leave you with that. All you have to do now to win a free trip is to tag a mate or someone that you know in this video, and just mention it in the comments section below. Even just tagging a mate, even if they're not in the video, will still get you in the draw, and we'll give away that trip over the next few days sometime, and get you out there on the water for what's promising to be a pretty good spring. There is a bit of an El Nino effect sort of starting to happen, so we can expect some warmer water temperatures, and it could be a little bit breezy too. So now let's hope we have a good summer, and let's get out there and do it. You can catch us on Facebook, you're obviously on that page now, it's Catching On, and our webpage is charterconnection.co.nz, where we have a list of dates and other things that are going on there as well. So stay tuned, and we'll keep you up to date with what's going on, and get you out there and doing